Welcome to the healthiest radio station in the Philippines, only here at H101 Radio. Today, I would like to welcome you in our health series called Healthy Choices for a Better Life. So make sure you have a pen and paper with you as we discuss some interesting topics for our well-known guest. Let's get started. She is a graduate of BS in Physical Therapy and at University of the Philippines. She is also a licensed personal trainer and health coach in ACE, or American Council on Exercise. She conducts her own group of fitness sessions, educating parents, especially moms, to continue on living a healthy life. She is 40 years old and she's a mother of 3 wonderful kids. Let us welcome Coach Lavin Valebia.
Hi everyone, and thank you, Martin.
Hi Coach, thank you for letting us have this interview with you.
Of course.
Coach Lavin, can you share to us what is the importance of managing your time for exercise?
Okay, so ilang isang nanay, so usually maraming mga things na kailangan unahin ng isipin. Well, I like taking care of my three kids. Okay, so usually I manage my time. I woke up early in the morning. Okay, so after that, let us go to school, and then that is the time that I can exercise. So if my kids are at school na, so yun yung ginagawa kong time ko. Since ako, or to do some things na household work.
Ilang taon na po ba yung mga anak na?
So actually, their ages are 15, 10,
15, 10,
and 2.
2 years old.
Yes.
So when they're, yung dalawa po, pag nasa school na sila, yung 2 years old po, paano pa po kayo nakakapag-set ng time for exercise, especially pag 2 years old, syempre, madami yung needs.
Well, I let her join.
Sinasama niyo siya sa exercise niyo.
I let her join. So for example, we're just playing. We pretend that we play. So that is one thing that we do. For example, I'm cleaning the sink. Okay, so that is one exercise that I do. So you use your arms, right? So, and then the kids will do the same.
So okay. Talagang ginagaya kayo ng bata dun sa mga exercise. Tsaka ini-involve mo siya.
Yes.
So yung mga exercise pa to, usually, talagang sa loob lang kayo ng bahay or do you still go out?
Sometimes I go out. But mostly sa bahay. Kasi
Coach Lavin, do you prefer ba doing your exercises at home or mas gusto nyo bang joining a gym?
For me ha, mas okay sa bahay.
Bakit naman po?
Well, there are many things you can do sa bahay.
Okay.
And number one is less gastos.
Less gastos.
Yes, talaga. Yun ang importante, less gastos. So that's the important thing. And then second is also as a mom, check your kids.
Sabagay, mas mababantayan natin yung mga bata. Kasi meron tayong mga listeners dito for sure na mga mom na hindi nila talaga maiwanan yung mga anak nila. So ano naman po yung mabibigyan yung advice or what advice can you give them for the mom who doesn't have the budget to go to a gym and doesn't have really the time to go into a gym na they can just start working out at home. So ano ba yung mga workouts na pwede niyong mga ibigay na advice sa kanila?
Okay, so don't go to the gym to exercise. You can make it at home. Okay, so there are many things to do. So for example, mag-nap your kids mo or your kids will be at school. Okay? So, one thing is, jumping jack. Okay, so 1 minute. 1 minute, everything. 1 minute jumping jack, high knees, jog in place, kangaroo jump, what else? And then you rest after that, again. Repeat it again. Okay? And then increase your time.
So, after ng 1 minute, yung next step po ba dun is ini-increase nyo lang talaga yung time or babaguhin nyo rin yung workout na ginagawa?
It depends kasi wag natin yung sarili natin. Wag natin to push.
Yeah, wag natin masyadong pilitin. Okay. So, yes. For those who are listening, Coach Lavin is here na ina-advise niya talaga tayo na huwag natin kailangan pilitin, especially for the moms na talagang first time palang mag-exercise. We don't need to force ourselves. Tama ba, Coach?
Yes, of course.
So, Coach, what are the tips and advices that you can give for our moms and parents na nakikinig dyan and doesn't have the knowledge on how to plan an exercise routine?
Okay. So, usually, mothers, they know how to plan. Okay? So, you start with, for example, Monday. Okay? So, you know naman your free time. So, for example, your free time is around 9 to 11 in the morning. Okay. So, sa YouTube, maraming mga example ng mga exercise that you can copy. Okay? So, step by step. Okay? And then, for example, same time on Tuesday. So, same routine or not, okay, it's up to you. But the best is you do it by planning.
Importante talaga yung pagplano natin.
Yes. And then, hindi lang basta kunyari, no, umpisa mo for 1 week, you're going to stop it. So, dapat buong loob. If you plan to lose weight, so you have to make it, do it hard, okay, work for it, and do your best.
So, ang ibig mo ba sabihin dito, Coach, is for those parents or moms that are listening right now, na dapat they should plan out their whole week and plan out kung ano yung mga specific na exercise na gagawin nila.
Yes, oo. Kasi hindi lang basta, for example, you're going to run, okay, and jump, so you have to plan everything talaga.
Okay, so for those who are listening, so make sure that you have a plan for the whole week para talagang wala tong lusot tong exercises na to. Coach, as a mom, syempre sa bahay ka lang nag-exercise and mag-isa ka lang. Ano yung mga common excuses na nasasagi sa isip mo pag ginagawa mo to?
Well, since I have a toddler, so tamad factor yan, isa yan. And then, I'm too old. Child na matanda para sa ito. Everything. And then, the third is, I'll do it tomorrow. Bukas na lang. So, that's it.
So, Coach, what advice can you give to our listeners para matulungan din silang ma-overcome tong mga excuses na to?
Okay. So, first is, make a plan. So, if you want to lose weight, okay, you have to make time and effort, okay? But not just for 3 days or for a week, okay? But every day. So, continuous planning. Okay? And second is, give it all out. Okay? Not just your body, but also your mind and your heart. So, that is why I suggest that you give it to everyone so to keep a positive mind. Stay focused on your goal and to achieve your plan.
Okay, thank you, Coach, for that very encouraging advices ng mga senior mo, especially malaking tulong to dun sa mga listeners natin. And Coach Lavin, again, thank you for letting me have this interview with you. I know may mga chores ka pa na dapat gawin at mga appointment na dapat i-attend. So maraming salamat talaga, Coach.
Okay, so thank you for having me.
Thank you, Coach. There you have it, folks. Thank you for listening. And I hope na marami kayo natutunan sa araw na ito. Maraming salamat sa pagsubaybay and I hope na makasama ulit namin kayo sa susunod na series. Dito lamang sa LTS Radio Station in the Philippines, H101 Radio. Peace.